everyone. My name's Samantha and I suffer from endometriosis. In this video I'm going to be talking about the endometriosis diet. I've done a video on the foods you want to avoid, and this one's going to be focusing on the foods you want to be eating. Just to let you know, I'm not a medical care professional. This is just after doing a lot of research and also as I'm a sufferer myself, going off of things that you know have worked for me and things that haven't. However, this is really just kind of going off like what I found out. So when you've got endometriosis, you do want to be having a diet that is high in fiber, iron, and also essential fatty acids like omega-3 oils. So we'll start with the omega-3 oils. So they're found in things like chia and flax seeds, oily fish, pumpkin seeds, walnuts and walnut oil. By the way, just to let you know, if you see me looking down, I've got notes here just because I don't want to miss anything. And then you've also got hormone balance in foods, which is really important because obviously excess estrogen is really not going to help you, so you need to be eating foods that are going to help balance those levels out, and that's things like beans, peas, pulses, garlic, apples, berries, like raspberries, blueberries, blackberries and things like that, fennel, nuts and seeds, carrots, celery, rhubarb as well. That's a good thing to eat. So they're the hormone balancing foods. I mean, to be honest, just eating a fresh food diet does seem to be good for people. You know, you just want to be staying away from junk. And then another thing obviously is the fiber. So with fiber, obviously you want to be avoiding wheat and gluten. That's obviously not good, but anyway, this is focusing on the things you do eat. Silly me. Anyway, so fiber, so things like quinoa, plums, lentils, peas, beans, oats, nuts, fruit and vegetables as well, and they're quite easy to digest. And then chia and flax seeds. I'll mention that I'm going to be doing a video on a low FODMAP version of this because fiber can be a problem for people with IBS. I've got really bad IBS. it's not fun, and so obviously it kind of depending on what version you have, whether you've got the diarrhea version or the constipation version, you know, you've kind of got to be careful, even more so what you eat. So I'll be doing a separate video on that. So moving on to iron, obviously iron's really important because you do tend to have really heavy periods, so you really need to make sure you're getting enough iron. I actually have to take iron supplements as well because I'm always anemic. Dark leafy vegetables are really good. Obviously meats is really good for iron. However, with meat, the trouble is red meat obviously is good for iron, but it's actually really bad for causing inflammation because it promotes the bad prostaglandins. So you need to be really avoiding red meat if possible, but it's completely up to you. White meats aren't as bad and are on the list of foods you want to be eating that are high in iron. Beetroot, broccoli, if I didn't mention that, tofu, beans, pulses, nuts and seeds again, some of them are kind of cross over into the hormone balancing foods as well. Brown rice, and then you've got cereal can be good if it's iron fortified, and also iron fortified breads are good as well. So they're the things that you want to be eating. Just make sure, as I said at the beginning, you're eating a diet that is high in fiber, iron and the essential fatty acids. Everyone will find that certain things are good for them and certain things they want to avoid. Obviously everyone's different. I hope that's been helpful. If you've enjoyed this video, if it's helped you, please give it a thumbs up and comment. I'm quite new to this as well, so I just really want to kind of get the information out there and help some of you, you know. So, hopefully I've managed to cover everything. I don't know if I said subscribe, please do, and then check out my other videos on my endo related. I'm going to be doing quite a few of them as well in the future. So yeah, thank you for watching.